city of 13 million people, and many people felt this very large earthquake hundreds of miles from the epicenter. Just take a look at our office, and you'll see that what we have here on our floor is strewn papers. If you look at our tape library, the tapes have fallen all on the ground. And this is just one office, one small place that experienced the earthquake. I was at Tokyo Station, and really, that's where you felt the ground severely shaking because we were underground. And a lot of people who were there at the station were quite alarmed because even though this is a country where you do experience quite a few earthquakes, I mean, I've experienced dozens in just the short time that I've been here, this was dramatically different. You knew that this was different because it went on for quite a long time and the shaking was so strong. The train signs were moving back and forth and people were reacting differently. Normally, if there's an earthquake, you look at your watch and you move on. The difference here is that people were alarmed, and when the trains were shut down, certainly the concern level rose as well. But the Prime Minister has made sure that people understand what they don't want now in the aftermath of this is even more concern that's really not warranted here, that there be no panic, that people try to find their way home, make sure they connect with their families, start to free up some of the mobile phone lines, because that's been a real challenge here, trying to get through on any phone lines, and then try to get those rescue crews out of Tokyo or the nearby corresponding areas and to the hard-hit region. It is nighttime here. It is winter here. It is going to be a challenge trying to reach all those people and trying to get them out very safely. And as we can see from the pictures, it is devastation up there. But we may not understand the full scope of it until daylight in several hours.